Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 130th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Bandwagon 2.
One, ignition. Lift off the Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Bandwagon 2.
The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the 21st time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 4.
Stage 2 FPS is saved.
Landing leg deployed.
Impact shutdown.
We did get great views of those landing
legs. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a bunch of Falcon missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 12-2 mission, is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 23rd at 5:35 a.m. UTC or 12:35 a.m. EST. Later in the week, and we should see a customer mission launch. The Faria 4 NGS mission is currently scheduled for Friday 27th at 5 a.m. UTC or 12 a.m. EST. A couple of days after that, and we should see a couple of Starlink missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 11-3 mission, is currently scheduled for Sunday 29th for 1:35 a.m. UTC or Saturday 28th for 8:35 p.m. EST. A few hours later, and as mentioned, we should see another Starlink launch. The Starlink 12-6 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 29th at 5 a.m. UTC or 12 a.m. EST. SpaceX has secured some more crewed Falcon and Dragon missions. This post says VAST announces deal with SpaceX to launch two human spaceflight missions to the International Space Station. Heading to Boca Chica, work has continued on Orbital Pad B's launch mount. Work also continues on the Orbital Pad A launch site. SpaceX was seen recently removing their sign above the launch site entrance. They've also started destroying the beam that held the SpaceX sign up. Pieces for a temporary structure were seen being delivered to Starbase for the Pad B chopsticks. This structure was seen being assembled at the Pad B launch tower. SpaceX put on a cool little Christmas parade at Starbase recently. There are a bunch of nose cones for future Starships being worked on inside Star Factory. Here's a look at the full Starship 33 static fire test we saw last video. After the testing, Starship 33 was rolled back to the production site from Massey's test site. It was moved into and lifted inside of Mega Bay 2. Booster 15 was seen being moved inside of Mega Bay 1. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.